Good morning all. In the previous video, we have studied how to derive a differential equation for a damped harmonic oscillator. The equation was d square x by dt square plus 2k dx by dt plus omega 0 square x equal to 0. Equation number 3. So this is the differential equation for a damped harmonic oscillator. Differential equation for a damped harmonic oscillator. Okay, and we have seen that in the previous video 2k is equal to b by m and omega 0 square is equal to c by m. In some textbooks, instead of b, gamma has used, so don't be confused with that. Okay, so today our problem is we have to find a solution for this differential equation. That is, in terms of x with respect to t. So, we assume a solution in the form x is equal to a e raised to alpha t. X is equal to a e raised to alpha t. I think you have studied how to solve this kind of differential equation in plus 2 classes, or you will be studying in the coming days. Okay, if x is equal to a e raised to alpha t is a solution of this differential equation, so this differential equation should satisfy the solution. That is, if we substitute for x, dx by dt and d square x by dt square should be equal to 0. So, we are going to substitute for that. So, here we need to find dx by dt. Dx by dt equal to a alpha e raised to alpha t. That is, differentiating e raised to alpha t. So, alpha will come out, e raised to alpha t. Then, d square x by dt square is equal to, again alpha will come out, alpha square e raised to alpha t. So substituting these three terms, x, dx by dt and d square x by dt square in the equation 3. So we will get alpha square a e raised to alpha t plus 2k alpha a e raised to alpha t plus omega 0 square a e raised to alpha t equal to 0. So we can take a common factor here, a e raised to alpha t. A e raised to alpha t, alpha square plus 2k alpha plus omega 0 square equal to 0. Here, if this equation a e raised to alpha t into alpha square plus 2k alpha plus omega square equal to 0 means either a e raised to alpha t should be equal to 0 or alpha square plus 2k alpha plus omega 0 square should be equal to 0. So, but here a e raised to alpha t cannot be equal to 0 always, because for all value of time a e raised to alpha t cannot be equal to 0. So, a e raised to alpha t cannot be equal to 0 for all value of t. Cannot be equal to 0 for all value of t. So alpha square plus 2k alpha plus omega square become equal to 0. So this is an equation, this is a quadratic equation in alpha. So here alpha will be having two values. So we get a quadratic equation in terms of alpha square. So in terms of alpha, we get a quadratic equation in terms of alpha, that is alpha square plus 2k alpha plus omega 0 square equal to 0. So alpha is equal to minus b, minus 2k plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac, 4k square minus 4 into a 1 into c omega 0 square divided by 2k. That is equal to minus k plus or minus square root of k square minus omega 0 square. Minus k plus or minus square root of k square minus omega. That is alpha having two values. So we will write it as alpha 1 and alpha 2. Alpha 1 is equal to minus k plus square root of k square minus omega 0 square. And alpha 2 is equal to minus k minus square root of k square minus omega 0 square. So alpha is having two values here. So hence we can write a general solution for this differential equation in terms of alpha values. So the general solution of this differential equation is x is equal to a e raised to alpha t. So here two solutions are there for alpha. So we can write x is equal to a e raised to alpha 1 t plus another constant b e raised to alpha 2 t. Substituting the value of alpha 1 and alpha 2, a raised to minus k plus square root of k square minus omega 0 square into t plus b into e raised to minus k minus square root of k square minus omega 0 square into t. That is equal to, here e raised to minus kt can be taken out. So e raised to minus kt, a e raised to square root of k square minus omega 0 square into t plus b into e raised to minus k square minus omega 0 square into t. So this is equation number 4. This is equation number 4. E raised to minus kt, a e raised to k square minus omega 0 square into t plus b into e raised to minus square root of k square minus omega 0 square into t. So we put an equation number 4 here. Here both a and b are constants and its value depend on the initial conditions. And depending on the values of k and omega 0, there are three cases in which a displaced body can be come to the equilibrium position. So there are three cases. So case one is when k square greater than omega 0 square. So this here the process is slowly it's called overdamped case. Case 2 square equal to omega 0 square. So here the process will be very quickly. It's critically damped case. Critically damped case. Case 3 is k square less than omega 0 square. It means the damping factor k is less than the natural frequency. So this case is oscillating. So here k is less than omega 0, so it is called underdamped case. Underdamped case. So these are the three cases in which a displaced body can be come to equilibrium position depending on the values of k and omega 0. Okay, so next video we will discuss each cases in details. Okay, so thank you for watching. See you in the next video.